Well, today I want to fill out my spring wardrobe and show it to you. So I have 8 different tops that I bought and brought home to try on and see if I think they're a good fit, if they're worth the money, if they're worth keeping. And I'll also talk about what my new rule is now whenever I'm shopping for clothes. Well, hi, I'm Dawn from The Minimal Mom. If we haven't met before, I'm married to Tom and we have 4 kids ages 5 through 10, and we love sharing tips and tricks about how you can simplify your house quickly, because living in a simplified house is awesome. It's so good and it just keeps getting better. And so we love to help you do the same, because we know it's not easy, but it is so worthwhile. And simplifying clothes has made a huge difference in my life too. We don't have so much laundry. It's easy to pick out what to wear in the morning. And I really feel good in the clothes I have in my closet now, and I would not have been able to say that just a few years ago. And so today I want to show you, I bought 8 different tops. I got them a few weeks ago and I've just had them around waiting to try them on and see if I really like them or not. I do not enjoy clothes shopping that much, so I kind of put it off and don't like it, but I am learning a few things as I go, and I want to share those with you today, including my golden rule of how I decide if I'm going to keep something or return it. So I want to get started showing you some of the different clothes that I got. So these are all tops, because actually all of my bottoms for spring and summer still work great. And so this first top is from Target. I got it because I liked the color and I thought the style might be nice. I like tops that are flowy and easy to wear. If I carry any extra weight, it's in my midsection, and so I like for my tops to be flexible in that way. So I generally pick tops that are flowy. I thought this red color was kind of pretty and springy, and so I grabbed it. What I forgot, and now, I mean, once I was trying it on today, I'm like, why did I even get this? Because it's cotton, and what I'm remembering that I don't like about cotton tops like this is that they get wrinkled. Like, you sit in the car, especially if it gets warm and your back gets sweaty, and then you get out and it's like all wrinkled up and then you're trying to straighten it out. So I wouldn't normally buy a top like this, now I'm remembering. The other thing is, when I put it on, it had like zero shape, and I don't think that it really did anything for me. It did not feel right, and so that is a very clear no, and that one will go back to the store. Also, when I was at Target, I grabbed this other light blue top, thinking that I really like the colors. I don't do capsule wardrobes. I've talked about that quite a bit. I just pick clothes that fit me and that I enjoy wearing. That is my golden rule. It has to fit right now, not a few pounds from now. I'm not gonna bring it home and have to make adjustments. When I'm at the store, it needs to fit right now, and I need to feel good in it, not be adjusting it, not have to suck in, not anything like that. And so I really like the color of this top. I thought the cut was nice. I generally like this style of sleeve, but when I put it on, I realized the material was very clingy. It's kind of like a sweater material almost, and I could tell right away that like my midsection, and I was not gonna like it, and I'd constantly be like tugging at it or adjusting it. So again, this was like a clear no. Now I'll show you the third shirt from Target. It's actually this one, and I almost didn't grab it, and the reason is because it was $24.99. And I generally like to spend $15 or less, maybe $16 or less, on any of my tops. And so it was $24.99, and I'm just like, I don't ever pay that for a shirt, especially not from Target. If it were from a bigger brand name store, then I would generally make an exception. But I saw it a few different times when I was at Target, and then I finally was like, okay, I'm gonna grab it. And I'm really glad that I did, because when I put it on, I love that the top is fitted, but then the rest of it is flowy, so it is very forgiving. I like the colors in it, and the pattern I thought was really pretty. And I really like that I think I could dress it up or dress it down. And so my 4 different pants, I have 2 pairs of jeans. One is more like ripped, and then the other pair is a little bit nicer. But then I also have a pair of black capris and a pair of white capris. And so I like that it could go with any of my bottoms. I could dress it up, dress it down. And I just thought it was very feminine and pretty and super comfortable and easy to wear. I could throw this on and not even have to think about it again. And so that I really liked about it. And so this, I think, is gonna be a winner. So those first 3 tops were from Target. I did have a shirt from Walmart, and I saw it on the rack and I was like, well, that's kind of cute. I like that it had like a linen texture to it. I like the colors of it. I like blue. And so I was like, well, this is kind of fun. But once I put it on, I realized that I would probably be constantly adjusting it, especially how the top layer kind of lays over the bottom layer and with the tie on the side. And I also felt like the sleeves were a little bit big. And so I kind of liked it, but it was a pretty clear no as well. And so that's gonna go back too. Now, this next shirt, I saw at TJ Maxx on the rack, and I loved it. I liked the color. It felt very summery. I liked the gold in it. So it's a little bit dressy, but not too dressy. I like the cut of it. And so I thought I was going to love this shirt. I was like sure of it. But then when I got home and I put it on, it's a little bit shorter than what I was expecting. And I realized that the tie in the front, I don't need to draw attention to my midsection at all. I'd rather have detail like at the top and just the rest be forgotten about. And then the sleeves didn't quite, I felt like I would be adjusting the sleeves a lot. And it just, I was really disappointed because on the hanger, I loved this shirt. But then when I got home, I realized that it would probably be one of those things that I would keep thinking that I would find a time to wear it and like it, but never actually wear. And so this one almost tricked me, but I am gonna pass on this top because I know I would be adjusting it and it's not something that I could just put on and wear and be comfortable. So the next two tops I got at Marshall's, and right away the embroidery detail on the top caught my attention, and I liked that it was different than I don't have any other shirts like this. And so I liked that it felt different. It wasn't like just kind of the normal tops that I buy. I really liked the blue color. And really, I have a pretty casual wardrobe now. I don't really dress up hardly at all anymore. And so I thought for spring and summer, it was kind of fun and it would be fun to wear. And so I was excited to find this top, and this is a definite win. And it was like easiest decision of all the tops that I got that I really wanted to keep that one. So I also found this kind of blush colored top at Marshall's, and again, I really like that it's flowy and so super easy to wear, but I thought the elastic around the sleeves was kind of fun, and I liked how it kind of bunched up then and made the tops of the sleeves a little bit fuller. And then I also thought the texture was really fun with it, with the pattern that it had on it. And it's also lined, so it's a little bit thicker. So again, doesn't like cling, is very forgiving. And so as soon as I put it on, I could just tell that I would be comfortable in it and I would enjoy grabbing it out of my closet and wearing it. And so I got one more shirt at Marshall's. Most of my clothes come from Marshall's or TJ Maxx or Macy's. I've had really good luck at Macy's. For sure, my pants usually come from Macy's, and I'm learning to invest in my pants and my capris because I get several years out of them. And then I spend a little bit less on my tops, but then I don't mind changing them up as the seasons change and the styles change. And I do have a few tops that I am gonna pull through from last year too, so I'll show you those two at the end. So the last shirt, again, is from Marshall's, and I just thought the colors were fun. The stripes are going vertical, right, which is supposed to be more flattering, and I thought it would look nice in videos, especially when you just see like top up. And so I really liked the colors. I thought the little ruffle on the sleeve was kind of fun, and the buttons. And so it's, again, very easy to wear, very comfortable, doesn't get wrinkly. I really like that about it. So I think that's a fun piece to add to my spring wardrobe too. So of the 8 tops that I picked out, I am keeping 4 of them. I wasn't sure how many. I didn't have like a number in my head when I went shopping. And so I am gonna keep 4 of them. The other thing I've learned, at least for me, is to not shop online. I have had terrible luck shopping online. I've maybe found one thing, but most of the time I end up being really disappointed with what I find online. And now once my spring wardrobe is complete, I try to just avoid the clothing sections. I don't go through the clearance rack at Target. I just stay away, trust that I have enough clothes at home because I have things at home that fit and I feel good in. And now for the rest of spring, I won't do any more clothes shopping or impulse buying. And then also from last year, I had this navy and white striped shirt that I really like. So I'll be wearing that again this year. And then I do get asked the question, like, if you find something you really like, do you ever like stock up on it? And I do. So last year at Macy's, they had these really nice t-shirts. It's a scoop neck, and then the bottom is like scooped. And they're kind of a knit ran mixture. And they were on sale for like $12 last year. And so I got 3 of them. I got a black one, an emerald green one, and then kind of a black heather one. And I love them. They're comfortable. I like how the sleeves fit. I like the colors. They wash up awesome. And so I got those last year, and I'll be wearing them again this year, and definitely a great investment. The price was great, but they're really good quality. And so I'm really glad to have those in my wardrobe. So between those t-shirts and these other shirts that I got, I have more than enough. This is actually probably more than I normally have in my wardrobe. But what's funny is that I don't ever feel like when I see people that I'm wearing the same thing, like if I go to church or just out and about, I never feel like people think that I'm always wearing the same thing, but on videos, I often feel like I'm always wearing the same thing. So my wardrobe's a little bit bigger probably now just because I like to wear different things in videos, but not for the people around me, really. So it's kind of funny how things change. So this really is plenty. And around the house, I just wear leggings and t-shirts and it's very casual. And so this is more of the stuff I wear if we're gonna go somewhere. And then for shoes, I got these shoes last year and they're still in great condition. They're very comfortable and I love that they're neutral, so I can wear them with any color, dress them up, dress them down. They are perfect. But I would love to know, have you had a chance to go through your spring clothes? I have some videos on easy ways to simplify your wardrobe because I know that can be a little bit daunting, but if you do have some extra time right now, it would feel really good to get your closet simplified. So I do think it's worthwhile, even if you're doing the quarantine bin, you're tucking stuff away to see if you're gonna miss it or not. So I think that would be a great thing to do right now if you do find yourself with a little extra time. But I'd love to know, do you need to round out your spring wardrobe or do you have enough stuff from last year? Do you do a capsule wardrobe? I'm always curious to hear that too because I know a lot of people have good success with that too. So leave that down below. But I really hope that this finds you well. I hope things are starting to settle in a little bit and we will definitely visit with you again soon.